Hello, followers. Welcome to this video. Let's get a general and complete overview on everything you need to know to start using Adobe Photoshop CC Release 2019. Leave us tips and suggestions below this video to improve our next tutorial dedicated to Photoshop CC. Adobe Photoshop is a professional digital imaging software product used to realize photo corrections and manipulations, vector graphics and titles, and artistic drawings and creations for advertisements and illustrations. This product is available just under a subscription plan. When opening Photoshop, the home screen page shows up, divided in several sections from the left. Under Home, you can take a quick tour if you start Photoshop for the first times. And under Recent, you get all your documents and photos edited with Photoshop. Inside Learn, you find all the latest news, tips, and tutorials from Adobe. Under LR Photos, all the photos taken from your Lightroom collections. In addition, use Create New to start with a new Photoshop document, or Open to open and start from an existing project or photo. When creating a new document, the New Document dialog box shows up to pick the right template to use. On top, under Recent or Saved, you can find all your recent or saved custom templates. Otherwise, you can choose any section from Photo to Film and Video to start from any ready template available. Once the template is chosen, use the Preset Details panel to customize the document options, such as its width and height, its orientation, resolution, color mode, and other properties. Once you click on Create, the new document shows up as a single empty page with a white solid background. You can also open other projects or photos by going to File and then to Open. All documents and photos are listed under tabs on top, complete with their own name. The main workspace is divided in several parts. On the left, you have the Tools bar, collecting all the tools and features inside several buttons, from top to bottom. Some of these show a white corner and group multiple tools inside. In this case, just right-click on these to open the full list of the tools inside. On top, you have the menu and also the options bar, showing all the properties for the current object or tool selected. It also includes the Home button, used to open the home screen page seen before. You can come back to the main Photoshop interface from here by clicking on its icon. On the right, you have several panels to manage your corrections and modifications. In case any window is missing, you can reopen it by going to the Window tab. The rest of the workspace is dedicated to the main preview, where you check and edit your document in progress. You can also zoom in and out around your pointer with your mouse wheel while holding down the alternate key, and pan through the document by holding down the spacebar key and clicking and dragging on it. Let's understand how Photoshop works. When you create a new project with a chosen template and size, or you simply open an existing photo, you always work within a Photoshop document, which is the page shown on the main preview. This document can collect several independent objects called layers, which can be images, vector shapes, text, and adjustments, all shown under the Layers window on the right. At first, you have just a single layer, which represents the white background in case you start with a new document, or the image itself if you open a photo. In case any layer is locked and in italic, just double-click on it to start editing it. You can adjust the document size anytime by enabling the Crop tool and editing the grid appearing on the document. Use its nodes to scale and size the document, and click and drag on the grid to move it. You can also rotate it by clicking and dragging from outside. Any checkerboard area you see is just an extra empty space created, completely transparent and without any background. Inside the options bar above, use Cancel to undo the tool and Commit to apply it. Now, let's see how to work with photos and pictures. To import an image inside your document, just open it on the preview, enable the rectangular marquee tool, and click and drag on the image to select it. After this, go to Edit, Cut, and then switch to the document where the image must be imported. At this point, go to Edit, and then to Paste. The image is added as a new layer and shown under the Layers window. Images, photos, and backgrounds are also called pixel layers, which are rendered objects with defined pixels. To start editing, just select one from the Layers window and enable the Interested tool from the Tools bar. Use the Brush or the Pencil tool to brush freehand on the picture. From the Options bar above, adjust the brush size, hardness, and style. Use Mode to set the way to apply your brush, and Opacity to adjust its transparency level. To choose the brush color, you can use the Color window on the right, or pick the color directly from the screen by holding down the Alternate key. Use the Healing brush and the Clone stamp tools to correct and cover parts of the image by using its same pixels as reference. First of all, hold down the Alternate key and click on the image to fix a reference point. When you brush on the picture, you paste a copy of the pixels that are under the reference in that moment, represented as a small cross. If you use Clone stamp, you paste the exact pixels of the picture. If you enable Healing brush, you paste the pixels by saving the highlights and the shadows of the original part you brush on. Always use the Options bar to adjust and set any brush property. Use Spot Healing Brush to apply Healing Brush corrections on limited portions without defining any reference. Other tools can apply advanced corrections and effects by brushing on the picture. Use the Blur tool to adjust blurriness, the Sharpen tool to sharpen the details of the picture, the Smudge tool to drag and slide its pixels, the Dodge and the Burn tool to increase or decrease the exposure level. In this case, use Range on the Options bar to set where to edit the exposure, such as the image highlights, midtones, or shadows. Use the Sponge tool to decrease or increase the color intensity, according to what you choose on top between Desaturate and Saturate. You can also delete pixels from the picture by brushing with the Eraser tool, setting brush size, feather, and hardness on the Options bar. If you make any mistake, use Control or Command and Z to undo your last actions in order. You can open the History window to get the list of all your actions to undo or redo these. Inside Photoshop, you can also realize custom drawings and illustrations by using vector shapes. In respect to images, these are not rendered into pixels, so they do not lose quality and resolution when you size or edit these, until they are converted into pixel layers. You can use any shape tool to draw vectors, such as polygons, lines, or custom regular shapes, by clicking and dragging on the workspace. From the Options bar above, adjust the fill color and the stroke color, thickness, and style. Besides these kinds of vectors, you can also create pieces of text called type layers. Just enable the Type tool and click and drag on the preview to create a text box, which delimits the text distribution. After this, type inside it, horizontally or vertically, depending on the kind of type tool you have chosen. Then use the options bar above or the character window to adjust the font family, size, style, distribution, and color. All your changes are applied just on the piece of text you have selected. To undo or apply text, just use Cancel or Commit on the options bar. Vector shapes and text can be rendered into pixel layers in order to apply brushes and corrections on these. On the Layers window, right-click on the vector or text interested and go to Rasterize Layer. Consider that this action is permanent, so you can't come back to the original vectors. You can apply basic editing to any pixel or vector layer selected from the Layers window by going to Edit, Transform. At this point, click and drag the object to move it and use its nodes to scale, rotate, skew, or distort it. In case you use scale, hold down the Shift key to scale freely. In case you rotate, enable the anchor point above to change the reference point as you rotate. Use the options bar to adjust the object properties, such as its position with X and Y, its size in width and height, saving the aspect ratio with the link button, its inclination and its skew degrees. Use Cancel or Commit to undo or apply your modifications. You can also right-click on any layer and go to Blending Options to add transparency, contours, and special effects such as shadow or glow outside or inside the layer. These are also shown within the Layers window. The Layers window is also used to manage the layers and arrange their visibility order in case they overlap. For example, if a text layer is placed below another object, this gets completely covered by it. If you click and slide the text above the object in order, this appears in front of it. In addition, you can use the I button to hide or show a layer, or the lock buttons above to block several modifications on the selected layer properties. To remove and delete an object, just click on it to select it and use the bin button at the bottom. Inside Photoshop, you also have the selection tools. These are used to take just a limited portion from a selected layer from the Layers window in order to cut, copy, paste, or brush just on such region. There are different kinds of selection tools. Use the marquee tools to create a rectangular or an elliptical selection area by clicking and dragging on the workspace. Use the lasso or the polygonal lasso to draw the selection area freehand or polygonal. And choose the magnetic lasso to select the region by following the color contours and contrasts. Enable the Quick Selection tool to brush and select portions sharing the same color gradients. You can also use the horizontal and the vertical type mask tools to select parts by following a typed text. To deselect all, just use Control or Command and D. Inside Photoshop, you also have the adjustment layers, used to apply advanced corrections on any kind of layer inside your document. From the Adjustments window, click on one kind of correction to add an adjustment layer inside the Layers window, correcting brightness, contrast, saturation, threshold, and other properties on all the layers placed below the adjustment layer in order. This layer is made by two parts: its properties on the left, and its layer mask on the right. Double-click on the properties to open the Properties window and tune the corrections applied by such layer while checking the preview. Click on Masks above to start editing the layer mask. This sets all the regions where the adjustment must be applied, represented under a white color over a black background. By default, a new adjustment layer is applied on the whole workspace, showing a layer mask completely white. But in case you create an adjustment layer while having any selected region, only this part will be affected, as it is shown on the layer mask. The layer mask can be edited just like a picture. You can extend its white region by using the brush tool or remove any part by using the eraser tool. Let's see how to save and export your Photoshop document. Select the document interested, and then go to File, Save As, and choose where to save it and its file name. Under Save As Type, set its file format, such as .psd, to save the Photoshop document as it is, with all its layers, adjustments, and options. .pdf to render and print your document, and .jpg or .png to save the document as a picture, with all vectors converted into pixels. A .png format also saves any transparent region, whereas a .jpg format allows to balance the picture quality with its overall file size. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our YouTube channel for more and free video tutorials dedicated to Adobe Creative Cloud.